Coming up this week on the show,
we highlight STEM Club,
we check out local businesses,
and we get to see an exciting hobby.
It's Friday, March 29th,
and the buzz starts right now.
I'm Tanner, C-Cat,
Giggles,
Rascal,
Kiki,
Brady!
I'm Mac.
Happy Friday, Fort Mill. I'm Kim.
And I'm Jackson. Here's Claire with a sports update.
Hey Fort Mill, I'm Claire Olson with the Buzz Sports.
One word to describe how you're feeling right now, what word would that be?
Smug.
Exceptional.
As we are heading into spring break, our athletes took no breaks and played like Yellow Jackets this week.
Boys soccer crushed the Falcons 1-0 in penalty kicks. Girls lacrosse played on Wednesday, 8-6 and 1. Girls soccer played Blythewood on Thursday and lost 2-0. Boys lacrosse played Boiling Springs and lost 13-7.
Good job to all of our sports teams. Ayla went ahead and asked you guys about your sports superstitions.
Hi, I'm Ayla, and today we're going to ask our athletes about their superstitions.
I go right sock, right shoe, left sock, left shoe.
I'm Sophia. I do track, and my superstition is that Ayla has to braid my hair before every meet.
My name is Peyton Goss McDowell. I do pole vault and have to breathe short, long, long before I run.
Hey, my name is Harper. I play basketball, and my superstition is I have the same warm-up routine before every game.
My name is Thomas Mabry. I play football at Fort Mill High School. And I always wear the same socks every game day.
Hey, I'm Claire Olson. I'm a varsity swimmer, and my superstition is actually slapping myself on my arms and legs before I get on the block.
My sport superstition is that I wear the same socks when I go to my wrestling tournaments for good luck.
My name's Gabby Giorizzi, and my is that I eat a peanut butter and jelly before every game.
It's so funny to see athletes' routines before their game. Griffin got to recognize a small Fort Mill business.
Here's Ed Curry to explain more about his story and his business.
This is Ed Curry, the founder of Puckerbutt, a local Fort Mill business known for its fiery hot sauces, world record peppers, and delicious seasonings.
I'm Smokin' Ed Curry. I'm the president and owner, mad scientist, and chef at the Puckerbutt Pepper Company. Puckerbutt Pepper Company is a purveyor of the finest hot sauces in all of the United States. We also grow our own peppers and make pepper mash and pepper powders for major manufacturers as well as ourselves.
Not only do his peppers and sauces taste great, they also have amazing health benefits.
I did research in peppers to find a cure for cancer or heart disease. And that got me started in the hot pepper world. And that's how I really started doing all of this. There's a key on every pepper capsaicinoid that fits in a cell, or a keyhole on the cancer cell, and it causes what's essentially an autoimmune sequence. For heart disease, it actually cleans out your blood system. It elevates your metabolism, so it helps in weight loss. Not my weight loss, though, because I like the peach stand donuts. The science is unlimited.
Ed may run a successful business now, but his journey was marked by dark days battling addiction. Now, he's passionate about helping others on the road to recovery.
When I got clean, I learned values that through the 12-step programs that had to do with integrity and honesty and all the things that don't happen when you're doing drugs. When we take someone who even their family has kicked out onto the street and we give them a job that requires huge amounts of responsibility and show that we trust them, it lets them know that they have value in this world. And by building that self-awareness and that self-trust and that value, they become better people and learn to become, you know, productive members of society.
If you want to try out some of Ed's famous hot sauces, he has a shop on Main Street, Fort Mill. Reporting for The Buzz, I'm Griffin.
Wow, that story was fire, just like their hot sauce.
Something else that's hot is coffee.
And what's better than a local coffee shop?
Here's Alex to highlight the Humble Cup.
If you're looking for a place to get a cup of coffee over spring break, or just somewhere to relax after school, then consider stopping by Humble Cup.
Yeah, so we actually roast our own coffee. So our facility is actually in Davidson, North Carolina. So it's all roasted every single Monday, so the coffee's always fresh.
Despite operating as a coffee truck for many years, they've opened up a physical location on Tom Hall Street in 2023.
Started 5 years ago in my garage where I was roasting it myself, and then we kind of outgrew the garage. The shop opened up about a year ago, but this was always a hobby of mine that I started. So started in 2019. So it's really just coming in, making sure everything is turned on, the machines are turned on. Mainly just getting ready for the day with customers coming in. The morning rush, maybe more people going to work. The afternoon, maybe more people just hanging out here.
In addition to serving coffee, they also take part in the community by donating to charities and hosting local art competitions.
Yeah, so we showcase different artists all throughout the year. Every 3 months, we have a different artist that showcases their artwork on here. So we've been doing this since we've been open, and it was just a way of giving back to the community by allowing artists to show their creativity.
The place is only a 9-minute drive from the school, being located at 414 Tom Hall Street in Fort Mill. If you want to learn more, go to their website at www.humblecupcoffeeco.com. I'm Alex, reporting for The Buzz.
That could be a great place to visit during spring break.
Plus, it's local and a short drive.
Speaking of driving, Avery got to speak to Matthew about his racing.
So this here's my Cadillac DeVille. This is one of the last muscle cars that Cadillac ever produced. Under the hood, it's got the big North Star engine. These things were really fast back in the day. It's about the same size as a Mustang engine. And Cadillac, they stopped producing them because they stopped being a racing brand. So my brother-in-law, he's been racing this same autocross race for a while. And he came to me and he said, we need another driver. So he let me in. I was able to get a spot in the race. And my first race ever, you know, it didn't go well. It was a starter race. But it's just, you keep learning over time. You learn, you get better and better. And racing is all about experience. That's really the key to building any kind of skill. It's just to get better and better. Never again can I play a sport or compete in any competition and say, this is the most fun, most exciting thing I've ever done. Because racing surpasses all that. The type of skills that racing takes, this perception, this know-how, is something that no other sport will ever teach you. Guarantee you.
Nice!
Racing is a really cool hobby.
Fort Mill has a lot of cool hobbies you can join.
Aiden got to show us STEM Club.
I wanted to start STEM Club because me and Xander both are interested in STEM careers. He wanted to give other students the opportunity to have access to STEM opportunities and the chance to compete for what they enjoy.
So we're just exploring STEM careers and figuring out like what you want to be. We want to help you figure that out. We're also going to do projects to figure out to potentially go into competitions later in the year.
So I originally joined STEM Club because I wanted to pursue a career in automotive and mechanical engineering. So one of my friends told me about this opportunity, and I figured I'd give it a go, see what I thought about it. So one of the things I've enjoyed most about STEM Club is I really like coming up with cool solutions and cool new ways to come up with problems. So one of the things that I like to do is I like to take things back to the drawing board.
For more information like when they meet and topics regarding past meetings, you can follow their Instagram, which is at fmhs.stemclub. And you can also join the Google Classroom with the following code listed CXRO70Q. They meet currently at Mr. Doar's room, which is E107, on Thursdays in Flex. I hope to see you there.
That looks so awesome. I might want to join.
Well, that's all we have for you this week.
Have a wacky Friday, Fort Mill.
Hey, everybody. I know I got the big hat on right now, but I got some other news. We're going to have some big shoes to fill going into next school year. For the last 4 years, this Buzz has been working his tail off, and now I'm looking for the next Buzz that's going to make sure to fill this uniform. So if you're interested, again, reach out to the cheerleading coach and the athletic booster club, and more information to come on what you need to do if you are interested in being the Buzz for the future years to come.